Well guys, welcome into today's video. This is the big day in which we talk about Cathie Wood and ARK Invest once and for all. Let me be very clear. Cathie Wood and ARK Invest, they have become celebrities in the stock market. Look at this video. 2 weeks ago, this was posted. Almost a million views. This video is going well over a million views. This is how many people are checking for Cathie Wood and her opinion on the market and want to actually hear her opinion on the markets, stocks, things like that. That is absolutely unbelievable. You don't get those type of view counts and not be a celebrity in the stock market. The only person really touching those sorts of views when it comes to the stock market is people like Warren Buffett, okay? He was the only person that was hitting like millions, where like literally millions of people would tune in just to hear what Warren Buffett has to say about different stocks and the market in general, okay? And it's not just a fame that Cathie Wood has attracted on social media and the stock market in general and even like mainstream media. It's honestly, you look at the numbers of assets under management, it's in the tens of billions of dollars. Keep in mind, ARK years ago was in the tens of millions of dollars when it came to assets under management, and now they're in the tens of billions of dollars. Like this, their ETFs have become massive. So many investors from all over the world, small investors, mid-sized investors, large investors, are putting money into ARK funds. And this is why we have to talk about this here today. Two things in this video I wanna talk about, okay? We're going to talk in depth about Cathie Wood and ARK Invest, okay? We're gonna go in depth there. And then we're gonna talk about my opinion on investing with them. What you must know before you invest your money with ARK Invest or Cathie Wood in general. And this coming from a perspective whether you're going all in and you're investing like, let's say all your money or most of your money with ARK funds, or whether you're investing just partial, okay? We'll talk about all that. And I'm seeing it like right in front of my face, not just in terms of like, I see the view counts, I see like the assets under management they have, those numbers, but also when I go through people's portfolios, I'm seeing more and more often in my private group, people having pieces of their investment portfolio in ARK funds. Like I'm seeing it consistently across the board. So this should be a very interesting video. I hope you guys really enjoy this. If you don't mind, smash that thumbs up button. Help this guy stay healthy, okay? So I can afford some multivitamins, okay? If you don't mind, smash that thumbs up. That helps us out huge in the YouTube algorithm. And this is a video I definitely want a lot of people to see because I think it's on a subject that a lot of people need to think about from a few different angles, okay? And I think this is real big. All right. If you want to join Stock Hub, it is absolutely free to do so. That is the best and biggest free Discord chat in the world when it comes to stocks. And I might even start an ARK tab in there. I don't think we have an ARK Invest tab, but I might actually start one because so many people are dang investing in the ARK ETFs. I think it makes sense to honestly start an ARK tab in there ASAP. Okay. Alrighty, guys. So let's talk about this. All right. So when I started investing in Tesla stock, you know, back in, it was like 2019, I started looking into the company really, really in depth in like 2018. I'd followed the company since like, I think 2011, but I never invested in it. And finally, like late 2018, I started thinking about it as a possible investment. I started investing in it. And there were three people that consistently came up, and I really liked their views when it came to Tesla. I'm always willing to listen to anybody's point of view. I always give people the respect, okay? I don't care if they're a short seller, a long-term investor, I don't care if they come across as crazy. I'm always willing to at least give people respect and hear them out on their opinion when it comes to a stock. And there were three people that made more sense to me when it came to Tesla stock than any others, okay? The first one was Galileo over at Hyperchange. I watched his videos and they made a lot of sense coming from so many different perspectives around Tesla stock. And when I'm about to go big in on a stock, I love to hear other people's opinions. I don't ever make an investment decision based upon another person's opinion. That's regardless of who they are. I don't care who they are, but I'm always willing to hear them out. And every time I'd watch Galileo's videos on Tesla, I found his views and my views would align. And I just was like, this guy is really smart. You know, he's still super young, but he was really, really young back then. And I was like, this guy knows what he's talking about, okay? Ron Barron, he was the second person. Ron Barron, I'd watch his Tesla interviews on why he was investing in Tesla. And it just made so much dang sense. And I'm like, his views and my views are aligned. We believe the same things. We believe Tesla can become this huge electric vehicle company plus much more. And he just consistently came up. And the third person is a person we're talking about in this video here today, Cathie Wood over at ARK Invest, okay? I never heard of this lady, like going back like 2-3 years ago, before that, I never heard of this lady in my life. But she consistently came up with these huge Tesla calls on like stock prices that were just unfathomable at that time. And you know, I'd watch these videos and I'm like, my goodness, her views and my views on this company are so dang similar. And it was interesting. She would always have to go back and forth with, you know, people on CNBC or different bears that were negative on the stock and things like that. Because keep in mind, not everybody was so positive on Tesla. I mean, even nowadays, even after Tesla's huge success, there's still a lot of negativity around Tesla. I haven't been on the Yahoo message boards for a long time when it came to Tesla stock. So last night I just went on there and oh my gosh, there's still so much hate around Tesla, the valuation. And it's been like that for the longest time. And she would go on there and defend Tesla. Time in and time out. And she would defend them as well as anybody out there, okay? And even I, when I would watch those videos sometimes, and I'd hear some of these price targets, even there were even times that I thought maybe Kathy was crazy. And that's coming from somebody that's a Tesla bull, okay? But here's the thing. She might not be so crazy, okay? When she put out her $7,000 expected value for Tesla stock for 2024, I was like, that seems a bit much. Even coming from somebody that's super bullish on the stock that used to make a million Tesla videos back in the day. Like if you followed me years ago, I used to make so many dang Tesla videos. It was like ridiculous, okay? Like 2018, I kind of started, in 2019, it was like Tesla craziness, okay? But I remember her $7,000 price target that she came out with that like about a year ago while her and her fund, ARK Invest, right? And I was just like, that sounds ridiculous. That sounds crazy. Okay. Never mind the bull case of $15,000. I was like, that sounds just silly. Okay. But here we are today. We're in January of 2021 as I'm recording this video, and Tesla stock is $730 a share. Okay. Now it's done a 5-to-1 split over the time. So basically Tesla's true stock price now on a split adjusted basis is $3,650 per share. And we're in January 2021. And now that $7,000 call she made, you know, last year, when it seemed like that was silly, that's very possible. And now if you were to say Tesla's going to that price, no one's laughing at you anymore. Everybody's like, that might be a possibility, okay? And last year at this time, that seemed just ridiculous. And keep in mind, her bull case, which is 2024, the stock hit $15,000. That's only like a 4X from here on a split adjusted basis, okay? These are big things. And so Kathy Wood should, you know, some people were looking at her like, oh my gosh, she's crazy. I don't think people are looking at her like that anymore, okay? And what happens when you have a massive hit like Tesla and you were going out there and you were saying, you were going against the grain and you were saying that this stock was gonna be a beast in the future? And it happened, okay? What happens when that happens? Well, people start taking you real serious, real fast. And when I say people, I'm talking about small investors, I'm talking about like mid-size investors, I'm talking about large institutions, investors with high net worth in general. They all see this. Like people pay attention and they see this and they see her success and they see those what were crazy stock prices that she was putting out there for Tesla, and they see it all coming to fruition, and all of a sudden they start taking her more serious than ever. And that happens for anybody. And that's how you go from tens of millions of dollars under management 5-6 years ago like they had to now they have tens of billion dollars of assets under management. People started taking ARK Invest and Kathy Wood real serious over the past year or so. And I gotta say, even I experienced this on a much, much smaller scale, but I experienced this as well, okay? Guess what? When Tesla stock started really going up a ton in November and December of 2019, memberships to my private group 2X'd in a 2-month span. A lot of people, you know, were kind of like iffy on me back then. And they're like, I don't know about this guy investing in Tesla. Tesla might be, you know, a bad stock or something like that. And a lot of people were very unsure of me. But as soon as Tesla started hitting big time, oh my goodness, memberships literally went through the roof. And then you add on top of that, since that time, I've had like countless 100% gainers. Elf on a Shelf, Fizzy Get Dizzy, The Planet, Very Good Food Company, Skyworks Solutions, Cruzy Doozy, Nordstrom, like stock after stock I've had that weren't just hits, were massive hits. And like nowadays, I'm at a place where I don't even have to pitch my private group anymore. Like literally, in videos back in the day, if you watch, like I'm like, hey, if you want to join my private group, just click the link down there. And I used to do deals and things like that. I don't have to do deals anymore. It's like application only. And we don't even front end sell it anymore because literally there's so much demand for the private group nowadays. And when you got it like that, you got it. Nowadays, people just get it. Like they understand, like if you join my private group, you're gonna make way more money off me than I can make off you. I can promise you that. And when it comes to ARC, this has happened on a large scale, okay? Like an incredibly large scale. And so ARC is now in a position where they have tens of billions of dollars of assets under management, and the money continues to inflow heavily and will likely continue to inflow heavily to ARC for the coming months, if not the coming year or two, okay? And so now ARC is in a position where they have so much money flooding into their ETFs and they have so much money to buy with that they can actually push up the price of their own stocks they are buying because they are buying so heavily, okay? Because they have so much dang money, and that money, like, it's expected to get invested, right? People aren't investing their money with ARC just so ARC can like keep it in cash or something like that. Otherwise, you can just do that yourself, right? People are investing in ARC so ARC can go buy those stocks that ARC has, you know, become famous with. Specifically, obviously, Tesla stock, okay? And so now they're in a position where they can push up their own stock price, but not just that, okay? People are looking for what stocks ARC buy now. What's their newest stock? People are searching for this all the time. A million people watch that Bloomberg video, and probably another million are gonna watch it, simply based upon the fact that they're trying to hear what is ARC buying next? What is the next stock that Cathie Wood and ARC Invest is purchasing next? And basically, people are just gonna flood money into whatever stock that is. It doesn't matter what stock it is. It doesn't matter. If they could buy any stock out there, and there's gonna be a large amount of people that are gonna go ahead and buy that stock regardless, because that's maybe the next Tesla stock or that's maybe the next big hit. And so that's the way a lot of people are viewing it. And it's not just like it's some small investor with, you know, $750 their name, okay? These are large investors. We're talking about millionaires. People worth 10 million, 100 million. Like people are following her. People are following ARK Invest, and they're putting their money in whatever they buy. They're checking. And so you get into this kind of like unbelievable cycle that ARK is in right now, okay? ARK has all this money inflowing, okay? So ARK can buy heavy their own stocks that they're already buying, right? With inflows, okay? Then you have a bunch of people follow those stocks and invest their own money themselves. They're not maybe putting money directly in ARK Invest, they're just buying those stocks. Oh, ARK Invest bought Square stock, so now I'm gonna buy Square stock, things like that, okay? Then, because all that money's inflowing, right? Between the fact that ARK's investing all this inflow of money and then other people are just following their trades or their investments, right? Those stocks start doing very, very well. And sometimes much quicker than a lot of folks expected. And when you have more and more success, more and more people follow you and more people invest into ARK funds, which just gets you in this beautiful cycle of you constantly having massive inflows of money like ARK does. They can buy their own stocks. It does end up helping out to a certain extent, push up stock prices. Bunch of more people find out the stocks you're buying because it has to be disclosed every 3 months. ARK has to disclose what positions they're buying and selling. And so it gets disclosed, bunch of people follow that, those stocks do well, and it's a beautiful cycle for ARK Invest right now, okay? And ARK Invest is making a ton of money off this. You know, Cathie Wood is obviously getting incredible amount of fame from this, and investors are doing phenomenal. People that are invested in the ETFs that ARK has are doing amazing, and the people that aren't but just are following the investments for the most part are doing amazing, okay? Now, with that being said, this doesn't take anything away from Cathie Wood and ARK Invest, like being very smart investors, okay? It doesn't mean just be like they don't get to this position they're in, right? Where they have this beautiful, like kind of, you know, perfect circle going around, right? They don't get to this place without being very intelligent investors, like very intelligent. And so don't take, you know, what we just went through away from the fact that they're very intelligent and they're making a lot of smart investment decisions, okay? And keep in mind, when it comes to investing, investing in anything is one big confidence game. The numbers only mean so much. The confidence is so huge. Whether you, let's say you're gonna buy a real estate investment property, right? It's all about confidence and looking at it and being like, I believe this property is going to be worth more in the future. And I believe this property is going to give me a cash flow, blah, 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 per month and this much per year. And at the end of the day, you can look at the numbers, but do you have the confidence to make that investment? And when it comes to stocks and investing in general, it's confidence. The numbers will only get you so far. I could tell somebody all the numbers in the world around a stock, but that might not be what actually gets a person to invest. It's about, do they have the overall confidence in their gut to invest in that? And that's how people can invest in startups. People can invest in money in companies that have $0 in revenue. They're worth literally $0, right? Just because they have confidence. Like if Elon Musk wanted to start some company tomorrow that is doing $0 in revenue tomorrow, he could raise billions of dollars for that company tomorrow if he wanted to. Certainly hundreds of millions, but probably billions. You know why? Because he's Elon Musk and people have confidence in him. And so even if the company has zero customers, zero revenue, and zero worth, people will invest hundreds of millions or billions of dollars with him simply because they have the confidence in him. Investing is confidence more than anything, okay? And when it comes to ARK Invest, they got the numbers to back it up. Their performance has been phenomenal. Look at the 1 year, look at the 3 year, look at the 5 year. It's all amazing. The 1 year specifically is really amazing. They have 115% 1 year rate of return. That's ridiculous, ridiculous. And that was as of September 30th. I can almost guarantee you when the new numbers come out, their performance will be even higher than that. Even higher than that, okay? Which is insane. We were fortunate to get 138% rate of return in the past 1 year for the public count calculated by Fidelity Investments. I can tell you almost everything went right in the public count this year, almost everything. I mean, like 90% plus of things went exactly as planned or even better than planned. It was the best year I've ever had in the stock market by a mile. I'm usually shooting for like 30% a year. To get 138% 1 year rate of return is ridiculous, okay? And so for ARK to get the numbers they're getting, you need so many things to go right. You just like, you know, it's obviously a lot of skill, a lot of things like that, but it's also some luck, and we must understand that because not every year you're gonna get 138% return, 115% return, okay? And so I can understand people putting money into ARK Invest ETFs. And I can understand why a lot of people are putting a lot of money into ARK ETFs, which obviously is happening. But with that being said, there are two things you have to consider before you go ahead and you stick all your money or half of your money or 10% of your money into ARK Invest. And these things are really big, okay? The first one is Joseph Carlson. I watched a video he put out this weekend, okay? And this video was awesome. If you didn't get to check it out, you know, check it out. Tell him I gave him a shout out, okay? Essentially, he put out this video that went super in depth on looking at past performance of other hot funds, ETFs, and things like that in the past that got super famous. And what you'll see if you watch that video or you're gonna watch that video, shout out, let me know if you guys got to see that video or not. But what you'll find, he goes through a ton of data. That goes back like 40, 50 years, we're even talking. And the fact is, essentially, when the masses start to get in one of these funds or ETFs or something like that, the performance usually starts to actually lag the market. Like you wanna get in like way before everybody else gets in, but when the masses get in and the huge inflow of money happens, the performance actually goes really bad for a lot of these funds, okay? And it's similar to like, imagine, you know, I'm gonna throw a pool party, let's say, okay? And I throw a pool party and I got all these people coming over and, you know, all these families coming over and things like that, okay? You wanna be like the first one in the pool when the pool's all nice and you can like enjoy it and things like that. And you wanna get out when, you know, all the kids are in it and they're peeing in the pool, right? And, you know, everybody's getting drunk and, you know, everybody's got, you know, spilling beer in there and like some guy gets in who just ran 3 miles and he didn't take a shower and now that pool water's nasty. You wanna get out by that time. It's good to be the first person and it's not good to be the last person in that dirty, nasty water, right? And when it comes to funds, ETFs and these sorts of things, a lot of that philosophy is very similar. You should treat it very similar. The fact is, when the masses have got in this, it's not usually the time to get in. It's not just look at, you know, and it doesn't mean ARK can't way outperform the markets over the next 10 years, 20 years, something like that. I'm just saying if you look at data, it never is done. It really isn't. It's all the great performance comes early on, and once the masses jump in, that's when the performance starts to lag huge, okay? And I mean huge, and it happens almost every single time, all right? Number two, and this is honestly even a bigger thing. For me, this is a bigger thing, okay? Like way bigger, okay? So let's say you have $10,000, right? And you're looking at this $10,000 you have in your bank account and you're like, I wanna invest this money in the market. And so you can invest it on your own. You can pick your own stocks, let's say, with that $10,000, or you can have ARK Invest basically invest that money for you, okay? If you're investing on your own, you're picking your own stocks, you're betting on yourself. That's what you're doing. You're betting on yourself that you're gonna be able to successfully invest this money. And if you basically have ARK invest that money, you're betting that ARK is gonna invest that money better than you could invest that money, all right? Now, keep in mind, you might outperform the market, you might outperform ARK invest if you invest on your own, you might underperform. All those scenarios could certainly play out, right? Same exact thing with ARK invest. They might do bad, they might underperform the market, they might outperform the market, maybe they keep getting great gains for the next 5, 10, 15, 20 years. We don't really know. But the fact is, you're either betting on yourself or you're betting on ARK, right? And you have to understand, if you're essentially putting your money, I don't care what it is, if it's an ETF, if it's a mutual fund, if you're investing in a hedge fund, whatever it is, you're taking your money and you're giving it to somebody else and you're saying, you're gonna invest it better than I can invest it. And so you're giving up that power. Now, for some people, that might make sense to give up that power. Some people just wanna invest in an index fund as something that tracks S&P 500. Respect, like if you don't wanna do the work, you know, I can understand, or maybe you just don't have the investor appetite, or you can't like, you know, control your emotions and things like that. Now these are all things that are just excuses and things that can be worked through. They honestly can. I've seen it time and time again with person after person. Just a lot of people don't wanna put in that work. They'd rather make an excuse like, well, I'm too emotional in my decisions. It's like, you understand you can get better at that, right? Just because you're a certain way doesn't mean you have to be a certain way. If you're willing to accept that and change that, you can change that. But some people don't wanna go to that place. They don't wanna do the research work. They don't wanna employ a strategy that is, you know, proven and things like that. So they just wanna give up partial power over their money or full power. And the people that give up full power are the people that aren't investing in anything for themselves. They're not picking their own stocks at all, okay? And then the partial people are people that are saying, I want to invest 10% of my money, 30% of my money, 50% of my money with ARK Invest or in an index fund or something like that, okay? And speaking for myself, I don't want anybody running my money, okay? If Warren Buffett said, Jeremy, I will invest your money. No, Warren Buffett, you're not, that's a guy I respect more than any other in the stock market by a mile, okay? He's like my mentor when it comes to investing in stocks. I don't want Warren Buffett running my money. I don't want Cathie Wood running my money. I don't want anybody running my money. I wanna run my money myself. Whether I do better or worse than other people, we'll see what happens over time. I'm always gonna bet on myself before I bet on anybody else. And what a lot of people don't get is money is fun. It's fun to make money. But I can tell you, self-worth is so much better. You could have all the money in the world and just feel empty inside and like you got no self-worth, no confidence in yourself and things like that, okay? You know, if somebody just, let's say you inherited $100 million, okay? You never had to work a day in your life. You might think that sounds amazing. I can tell you it's probably not so dang amazing, okay? Because you don't really have that self-worth. So what, you got $100 million from your daddy or something like that. If you're not doing anything and all you're doing is partying on a yacht every day, that's not a healthy lifestyle, that's not a healthy mentality. Self-worth is more important than money. A lot of people with a lot of money that aren't happy, okay? And there's plenty of people with not very much money that are plenty happy. And they live and they got a lot of self-worth, okay? There are plenty of janitors out there that live life to the fullest and they love life, okay? And there's plenty of janitors that hate their life. And there's plenty of CEOs that hate their life. And there's plenty of CEOs that are very happy. But at the end of the day, it's all about self-worth. It's more important than money. Every time we have somebody like hit the six-figure, seven-figure club in the private group, I almost always get a very consistent message. Thank you, Jeremy, so much for helping me, you know, da-da-da-da-da, and those sorts of things. And at the end of the day, like I respond, I'm like, hey man, I'm happy to have helped in any way, but at the end of the day, you did this, not me. Like you're the one that bought the stocks. You're the one that bet on yourself. You did this, not me. I can give you the strategy. I can give everybody the strategy,
But at the end of the day, who's going to put in the work and who's going to actually use the strategy and who's going to actually have the confidence to do it themselves? You bet on yourself. You're the reason you got in the six-figure, seven-figure club. Not me, you are. And that's like something I always try to bring out. And now we have so many people literally hitting that club that I have to order the awards in pallets. Like I have to order them at like $12,000, $15,000 at a time because so many dang people are hitting six-figure and seven-figure club. They bet on themselves and they deserve that. And if I look at my own self, if my bank accounts are at $0 tomorrow, there's no money in there. Like there's just nothing. If the public account tomorrow says $0 in it, and all my other, my big dog account, my big dog private accounts has zero, everything's at zero, okay? At the end of the day, I have the confidence, I have the know-how that I will be able to get the money back. Because for the last 12 plus years, I've been betting on myself day in and day out. And I don't put my money with anybody else. I bet on myself. And I know how to do things. And I know how to invest my own money. And I know business. And I know work. And I know work ethic. And at the end of the day, if you're counting on other people to make these moves for you, if you go to zero or you go to any number, you don't have it. You don't know how to get it back if it was given to you by somebody else. Self-worth is so much better than money. Keep this in mind, okay? Forever. My favorite poet, Mr. J. Cole. You know what he says? I hope that you scrape every dollar you can. I hope you know money won't erase the pain. And it won't, okay? And that's just some food for thought. Do you want to make your own moves or do you want other people to make the moves for you? And so to wrap up this video, I love Cathie Wood. I love the performance ARK Invest has had. I have a ton of respect for her, the thoughts, the process, the looking at the super future, not getting caught up in the short term, like trading mindset that so many people, like that's what I always like preach against, like the short term mentality of trying to make a dollar today and then get in and out of this stock. Like I love their long term perspective and looking at these companies over the next 5-10 years. I love all that, okay? And I have no issue if people want to put a portion of their money over with ARK Invest. I just always think it's important to understand that just because ARK Invest has had these incredible returns does not mean ARK Invest will continue to have these incredible returns. We've seen it time and time again where these hot ETFs and these hot funds, they peak and then we've seen it time and time again. Maybe they break the trend and maybe they're the ones that just destroy it year in and year out from here on in. Maybe they're the ones that break the trend, okay? But it is something to keep in mind. And it is something to keep in mind whether you invest in an index fund, ETF, you're basically putting your money over somewhere else because you feel that money can be invested somewhere else better than you can personally invest it. That's why I don't do that. I don't have any money in any index funds. $0 I have in index funds. $0 I have in any ETFs, mutual funds, hedge funds, nothing. I invest it all for myself. I'm always willing to bet on myself. I've been doing it for over 12 years now. I hope to do it as long as I'm on this earth. I will always bet on myself before I bet on somebody else. And that lets me have like sleep well at night. That lets me like look at my life and be like, I'm accomplishing something. I'm doing things for myself. I'm not just like forking money over to everybody else. You run my money for me. Because the self-worth, when you have a successful investment, and multiples over years and years and years, the confidence that gives you in so many other areas of life is astronomical. And so, just some food for thought, guys. I hope you enjoy this as always. I hope you learned a lot. If you don't mind, smash the thumbs up. That helps us out in the YouTube algorithm. Big time, I appreciate all you guys that are part of the thumbs up squad. If you want to join Stock Hub, it's absolutely free to do so. That'll be linked in the description. Maybe I'll even have that as like one of the pinned comments down there. If you want to try to apply for my private stock group, that'll also be linked in the description. Maybe I'll have that as one of the pinned comments as well. And without further ado, thank you for watching and have a great day.